Hello and Merry Christmas, guys. This is your host, Feasible Lima, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4. Today, we will not be doing Poland, as I have already covered that in our first ever episode, which was a test. Today, however, we will be starting on 1st January 1936, and we will be doing the German Reich. Now, my challenge here is to try and take over Europe, or at least quite a bit of it, without ending up in an eternal war that I can't finish myself with the Allies. So, let's start. There we go. Right, first off, I would recommend we start off with Rhineland on the German national focus. We then will definitely have to research equipment and weapons. I'm using a mod today that does not tell me that I can't research something because it's a bit early, so I can already research experimental rockets. Atomic research is a little bit glitched. So now that I've got the research slots filled in, I'm going to need some resources, but because I don't have many, if any, I'm going to have to borrow some from the British Malaya while I'm still friends with them. I'm going to fill this slot up with some factories, this as well. And I'm going to use up the rest of my factories to make artillery. Always try and fill up these two slots because they're the most important for if you're doing ground battles. We also want a bit more rubber, so British Malaya. There you go, extra factories. Nice one to get working. Hold on. That doesn't matter. Just got tricked by it again. So let's put it on max speed. I've got no divisions in basic training and unassigned divisions. Right. Let's go. Let's go put them on the border of France, eh? So we've got three civilian factories, we don't need to know that. We've got more airplanes, we don't need to know that just yet. Basic infantry, we don't necessarily need infantry at the moment, but hey, why not? Berlin. Might as well start deploying infantry ready for the war, if there is going to be a giant war. Cause. So whilst TOTS is going on, I'm just going to see what I can do with Czechoslovakia. So I know they are democratic, so I'm not going to take them over just yet, even though I can, but that's only because I have a national focus which already allows me to do that. Poland I can always take. Hold on. France is not. They might actually leave me alone if I do. If I take over Poland now. Let's see. Are they all trained? Yeah, they are all trained. Right, Germany. Let's see what you got. You got this dude, perfect. Now, because we are not in the Molotov-Ribbentrop pact with Russia, we don't have to share Poland if we take it over. Whoopee! But that only counts for when you're in 1936. If you're in 1939, you will automatically be put into it. Stupid dog in the background. And declare war. And do it quickly. And we got Rhineland back as well. Right, now might be a good time to get some planes. I'd say get all of these planes ready. Oh god, no, I don't want these. Perfect. So, when they are ready, I'm going to tell them to deploy over here. And now, because it's green, that means that I have air superiority and they have none. Which is a great thing. It also gives your soldiers a boost in where it adds an extra 10% to the estimated plan value. I'm going to want to befriend Japan. They're fascist for starters and they are pretty powerful. Even I wouldn't want to mess with them. China, however, is quite weak. I can force a government of another country to adopt this. No, I can't. I can send volunteer forces and I can create factions. Well, I already am in a faction. I think. Yeah, the Axis. So when I take over Poland, I'm going to take over Czechoslovakia as well, before the Europeans get pissed. Research radios. We've got 12 soldiers ready for war. But we're not just going to drag them into this war yet. We only drag other soldiers into wars that we struggle with right now. We're not struggling with this war, of course, because the Polish are weak in this game. In real life, though, they can be quite badass. Let's make a few more panzers. One thing I have learned from Aaron in the previous series that we finished yesterday and started yesterday was that you always want to go for the heavy tanks and then build up to the more the mouse. Because with the mouse, oh, you can annihilate any country really quickly. Any country. Actually, we might as well just finish researching tanks entirely. We've got 3 military factories. Let's start making a few more panzers. And even motorized. This dude. Just walk in there. Actually, send the whole lot over there. To go after Dante. Now, because we are befriending Japan now, let's go for. Yeah, why not go for the Anti-Communist Pact? Wow, they are defending Danzig really, really spare. Well, they're desperate to keep it, I can say that much. Now, because, like I said in one of the other videos, you should only really send your entire army swarming over there if you're about to win. I am about to win, as they are 87% towards capitulation. Make sure you have at least 85% before you do anything stupid like I did. So we'll train them guys up, let them guys recover. In the meantime, we'll improve our infrastructure to the max. Infrastructure, for those of you who are new to the game or just don't know what it does, it basically it provides a state of improvement of infrastructure and increases your supply power in strategic regions and increases your division speed. Simple as that, you just gotta read. I don't know why I did that, or why I didn't do that earlier. They're almost trained. We don't need this guy. I'm gonna go for the backroom backstabber, the Prince of Terror, and a smooth talking charmer. If at any point I cut out, it only means I'm talking to another person, but I will not cut out for long. Only a minute at max or so. Unless I say. But then again, I might as well cut out that part of the video. Go for war with the USSR. Should we risk it? I don't think so. Not just yet. Let's go for. Right, we need a bit more manpower, field of manpower, if we want to demand the Sudetenland and Czechoslovakia. Alright, they should be trained by now. Yup. Screw the national focus, they'll only just take up your time. You want to get them while you can, because before you know it, the allies will be up your ass. Might as well do something. There we go. Declare war. We've almost won the war. Great. Let's make a little more artillery, shall we? And then make a few more fighters after we've done this. Oh well. We'll stop doing that now. We'll start making the Panzer IV. No. There we go. We'll go for oil plant now. And it's about time we start making our own resources. We do need to be independent and ready for war after all. Anyway. Thank you guys for watching. Next episode, we will be advancing, or hopefully advancing, into the Netherlands, Belgium, and Luxembourg. We will also be advancing into Russia next episode, and I will see you soon. Thank you for watching. This has been your host, Feasible Lemur.